Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss polynomial functions and their graphs. Let's go ahead and do an example of sketching a polynomial function. The question is to sketch f of x equals x to the fourth plus 2x cubed minus 3x squared. Let's carefully work through it. Solution. The first step when sketching polynomial functions is to find something called the end behavior. And so to find the end behavior, you basically look at two things. You look at the degree of the polynomial and the leading coefficient. So in this case, the degree is 4. It's the biggest exponent. So we have an even degree. And the leading coefficient is the number in front of the term of highest degree. In this case, there's a 1 here. What matters is that it's positive. So we have a positive leading coefficient. That's the key, it's that it's positive. And then there's something called the leading coefficient test, or some books call it the end behavior test, which says that whenever you have an even degree and a positive leading coefficient, your end behavior is rises left and rises right. So I do it a little bit differently in my mind. Sure, I do have it memorized, but there's something you can fall back on in case you forget. So once you identify the fact that the degree is even and you have a positive leading coefficient, just think, what's the simplest function you know that has those characteristics? Well, y equals x squared is a beautiful function. It looks like this, and it rises left and rises right. So therefore, that's the answer to our problem. So really cool, right? Just think about simple examples you know, like y equals x squared, and that will lead you to the correct answer. Okay, now let's go ahead and find the y-intercept. So to find the y-intercept for any function, you always plug in 0. So f of 0 is equal to, so it'll be 0 to the fourth plus 2 times 0 cubed minus 3 times 0 squared. We get 0 plus 0 minus 0, so the whole thing is 0, so we just get 0. So f of 0 is 0, so our y-intercept is the ordered pair, 0, 0. Now we have to find the x-intercepts. So basically what we're going to do is take the entire function and set it equal to 0 to find those. These are also called the zeros of the polynomial. We're also going to find what's called the zeros. So x-intercepts are what you think of them as, you know, being something that's graphical, and then zeros are basically the numbers that you plug in that make the zero. And to find those, you take this entire function and you set it equal to zero. So our solutions to this equation will be the x-intercepts, and they will also be the zeros of the function. They're almost the same. The only difference is that you can have zeros that are complex numbers, and that's not true for x-intercepts, so there's a small distinction. In any case, to find the x-intercepts, or the zeros, you take the entire function and you set it equal to 0. Looks like we can factor out an x squared, and we have to think, what do we multiply by x squared in order to get x to the fourth? Well, x squared. And what do we multiply by x squared in order to get 2x cubed? Well, plus 2x. Last one's easy, we just need a minus 3, right? Because x squared times minus 3 is minus 3x squared. And this is equal to 0. This should factor further. We have x squared, and then here we can also factor this quadratic, I believe. So let's see, we need two numbers that multiply to negative 3 but add to 2. So plus 3 and minus 1. Yeah, 3 times negative 1 is negative 3. And then 3 plus negative 1 is positive 2. All right, so we have a bunch of factors equal to 0, or product equal to 0, so you can set each factor equal to 0. So we have x squared equals 0. We have x plus 3 equals 0. And we have x minus 1 equals 0. And I want to emphasize that the numbers up here matter. So here we have a 1, and here we have a 1. So from this one here, we're going to get one answer. We're going to get, I'll use a different color for this. This is going to give us one of the answers, which is x equals 0. So x equals 0. That's our first x-intercept. It's also a 0 of the function. And it has an even number here. This number here is called the multiplicity, okay? It has an even multiplicity. This is really important. Multiplicity. And because it has an even multiplicity, what's going to happen here is at this x-intercept or at this 0, the graph is going to touch and turn around. So it touches and turns around. Okay, so whenever you have an even multiplicity for your 0, it touches and turns around. Here we're going to get negative 3. And you notice there's a 1 here. Right? You just subtract 3, so you get negative 3. There's a 1 here, so it has an odd multiplicity because the multiplicity is 1. It has an odd multiplicity. And whenever the multiplicity is odd, it crosses the x-axis. And likewise, here we get 1 as an answer. That's our x-intercept, or a 0 of the function. And again, the multiplicity is 1, so it's odd. Multiplicity. So it crosses. So this information is very powerful because it'll allow us to graph. So if you have an even multiplicity on your 0, it touches and turns around. If you have an odd multiplicity, like negative 3 and 1 do, it crosses. Let's go ahead and try to do a graph of our function. So here's the y-axis. Here's the x-axis. There's x and y. And let's very carefully plot our zeros. We have 0. That's our first one. X equals 0. Right there. I put a giant dot there to really just really emphasize it. Then we have 1. So let's put that one here. And then we have negative 3. So negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Make the jots really, really big. There we go. And now let's draw our graph. So we know our graph rises left and rises right. And this is the key step. We're going to start graphing it. So it has to look like this, right? Because it rises left. And it gets really close to negative 3. And what happens at negative 3? Oh, it crosses at negative 3. So it goes down. How far does it go? We don't really know, right? But it goes down a little bit. And then it goes back up to 0. And then at 0, it touches and turns around. So it hits 0 and touches and turns around. Then it crosses at 1 and it goes back up. And there is the graph. Really beautiful, right? Let me do it again. Let me just do it again so you see it. So it does this, right? At negative 3, it crosses, goes down, comes back up. At 0, it touches and turns around. And then at 1, it crosses. That's how you do it. Really nice, very powerful technique. Obviously, you don't know the minimums. You could use a calculator to find that or some calculus. But the main idea is whenever you're graphing polynomials, you look for the zeros. Even multiplicity touches and turns around. Odd multiplicity crosses. And the multiplicity is the number that you see here, right? I've circled the multiplicities here. They were 2, 1, and 1. Hopefully, after watching this video, your math is a little bit stronger. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.